You have the pollen report for us tonight.
Yes, we do.
That's good.
He was going to go, yeah, the pollen,
no,
but he didn't.
No, I wouldn't do that.
Yes, reported by allergist Jim McDonald as we look at this week's pollen report. First of all, we've got maple, willow, birch, and ash pollen. They are gone. Mulberry and sycamore are low. Oak, moderately high. Mold has been in. Small airborne amounts, not much of a factor yet. The pollen concentration forecast, oak increasing. Hickory and walnut start in approximately a week. Grass and sheep's sorrel weed will probably not start for another couple of weeks. The high today got up to 70 degrees at 5 o'clock in the Waygo and Charlotte, and the low 45 degrees at 6 o'clock this morning. Currently, at the TV 93 Weather Tower, winds are to the east 5 to 12 miles per hour. No measurable precipitation yet, however, it is raining in the TV 93 viewing area. Our barometer is rising from 30.15, relative humidity 64%, current temperature 57 degrees, 14 degrees Celsius. Our sun will rise tomorrow morning at 6:19 and set at 8:58. National Weather Service in Marseilles reports scattered patches of light rain with some light rain showers and patches of heavier rain over southeast Wisconsin, southern Lake Michigan, southwest lower Michigan, and northwest Indiana. Movement was northeasterly at 25 miles an hour. Detroit reporting patches of light rain are over southwest lower Michigan, northeast Indiana, and northwest Ohio. Isolated heavier activity that may be aloft shown between Kalamazoo and Battle Creek. Live at Broadcast House, Storm Surge 3 radar shows light precipitation over a wide area moving into the into a TV Active 3 viewing area along the lake down in Indiana as well as in Ohio. So it definitely goes along with our forecast for rain for tonight. Kalamazoo and Van Buren counties weren't the only places being picked on by Mother Nature this week. Lake Charles, Louisiana had up to 20 inches of rain, 6 feet standing in the streets, 2 feet in many people's homes, people having to be rescued by helicopter, taking care of those that were injured, of course, first, and tornadoes, 3 of them touched down in New Roads, Louisiana, just north of Baton Rouge, destroying many homes, 2 people dead, more damage reports coming in from Louisiana. Also, tornadoes being sighted near Birmingham, Alabama, Burlington, Mississippi, and Biloxi, Mississippi, and flash flood warnings for southern Texas all the way into Alabama all the way through tomorrow, and they're expecting heavier rainfall through tomorrow with more flooding for the entire Gulf Coastal State region. For us, as you see, the rain is now extending into the northward direction as we're starting to get rainfall, as we saw on our radar, into the TV 93 viewing area, and it's going to be a very wet weekend. I'll get to that forecast in the state of Michigan after these messages.
Just a week ago, we had a tornado, and now we've got some volcanic ash.
That's right, Jim, and I'll be telling you more about that shortly. First of all, though, let's look at our high temperature today. It got up to 82 degrees at 5 o'clock in Newaygo, and the low this morning was 44 degrees. Currently at the TV 93 Weather Tower, winds are out of the east, 7 to 9 miles per hour. We've had no precipitation. Our barometer falling from 29.95. Relative humidity 51%, current temperature 73 degrees, 23 degrees Celsius. Sun will set at 9:02 and rise tomorrow at 6:16. National Weather Service in Marseilles reports a rain shower developing over northwest Illinois. Movement has not been determined. Muskegon, we're seeing some temperature inversion along western Lake Michigan shoreline, but no precipitation being reported. Live at Broadcast House, Storm Surge 3 radar shows no significant precipitation, just our normal nearby ground clutter. Well, the volcanic cloud that was born last Sunday morning with the eruption of Mount Saint Helens in southwest Washington, that was originally thought to stay south of us, moved over southern Michigan before noon today, covering an area from Benton Harbor to Port Huron. It is expected to spread over the entire state by the evening. The base of the cloud is near 25,000 feet, with the top near 41,000 feet above sea level. High-level winds will advance the cloud northeastward, and as it moves, it continues to become more diffuse. No ash has fallen to the ground in the Midwest. However, some high-flying aircraft have reported accumulations on their windshields. Scattered showers in the east may bring some ash to the ground. The most noticeable effect of the volcanic cloud in Michigan will be discoloration of the sun, producing a high haze. Also, as the sun rays are reflected and refracted through the volcanic particles, a brilliant multicolored sunset and sunrise tomorrow morning can be expected in areas where cloud cover does not obscure the sun. There is not enough ash in the atmosphere currently to have a major effect on temperatures or rain in Michigan. Elsewhere in the country, heavy thundershower activity along the Atlantic coast has brought tornadoes that touched down in Georgia and South Carolina. Property damage reported in Hopkins, South Carolina. For us, more sunshine heading in our direction with even warmer temperatures. And I'll have that forecast along with the state of Michigan after these messages. Mostly sunny across the state. In the TV Anti-3 viewing area, it's also mostly sunny, with the warmest temperature being reported by Nuevo. As we're looking at the TV Anti-3 viewing area now of 82 degrees, the coolest, 60 degrees, reported in South Haven. The National Weather Service says the forecast is for all four zones tonight, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and all of the counties in the eastern portions of the TV Anti-3 viewing area. For tonight, fair, with a low in the upper 40s. For tomorrow, a volcanic haze, hazy sunshine, with a high in the upper 70s, a little bit lower near the lakeshore. For Thursday, mostly sunny, with a high around 80, a little cooler near the lake. The extended weather outlook for Friday through Sunday, continued warm and dry, with highs in the low 80s, lows around 48 to 58. The marine forecast, we're looking for mostly sunny skies tomorrow, southwesterly winds 5 to 10 knots, and waves of 1 to 3 feet. Now with more news, here's Jim.
Okay, Mark.